Welcome to the first health channel made by an AI robot. Please subscribe and listen.
The secret to growing taller. I've gotten a lot of questions from guys, wanting to know if or how they can grow taller. The good news is that you can for sure get taller. I've done it a few times with people, especially family members. However, the bad news is that what you'll discover today, obviously won't work for everyone, especially if you're over the age of 25. But, even if you're over 25 and want to get taller, keep watching because there are certain things you can do and that'll still make an improvement at any age. Plus at the end, I'll show you two simple ways that can make you instantly look 2 to 3 inches taller. Things I've learned from some of my shorter friends. What causes tallness and shortness? So the first question is, why are some people tall and some are short? My dad is 6 feet tall. My oldest brother is 5 feet 11 inches. My second oldest brother is only 5 feet 8 inches. While I'm 6 feet 3 inches and my mom is 5 feet 4 inches in my immediate family, it makes no sense. So, picking the right parents isn't always a guarantee, unless both your parents are very tall. But I've always been tall, even before puberty. I'm the tall guy in the middle, played center for the basketball team, freshman year in high school. However, genetics will always play a primary role in everything, as does your hormone levels. Of course, you can't change your genetics, but you can improve your hormones and lifestyle, which can turn certain genetic factors on or off. This would be considered epigenetics. I don't like to make things complicated or boring because there are lots of various hormones, enzymes, peptides, and so forth which all play a role in height. However, the main hormones are thyroid, estrogens, and growth hormone and IGF. So, let me get right to it. Why you're short in boys: high estrogen levels accelerates the fusing of the bone and stops the growth plates from maturing. I'm sure you've heard short, fat, bald and hairy to describe certain guys. Well, the short and fat part is from high estrogen. The bald and hairy is from high DHT, dihydrotestosterone. And when both of these hormones are elevated, testosterone levels drop. So that's three negatives. So, the first goal is to have normal or low/normal levels of estrogen. Definitely not high levels. Secondly, you want to have high growth hormone levels, which will cause your bones to continue to grow, as long as the ends haven't fused yet, typically due to estrogen and older age. Lastly, you want optimal thyroid levels because your thyroid gland controls many other hormones and conversions. Optimal thyroid levels will help more growth hormone to convert to the more powerful IGF, insulin-like growth factor, using drugs. So, to achieve this optimal hormonal range using drugs, you would do a full hormone blood test to see where your levels are. Then, you would take an estrogen or aromatase inhibitor to lower high estrogen levels. But not an estrogen blocker. You don't want to block estrogen, you want to lower the levels to a normal, but lower level. You would also take growth hormone at the same time, along with small amounts of T4 and T3 thyroid. This is how it would be done with drugs. You would need a very smart endocrinology doctor to assist you with all of this. I know this formula works. I've seen it work a bunch of times. However, I am not telling you to do this at all and certainly not on own. I'm just letting you know what works, using pharmaceutical drugs and working with a very smart doctor. Unfortunately, this method won't be utilized by 99% of people. So, let's talk about how you can do it naturally. Natural ways to optimize your hormones. Remember, you can't change your genetics. But the correct lifestyle will maximize or minimize your genetic potential. Sleep. The first thing you must do is get quality, deep sleep every night. This is when the majority of your growth hormone is released. Most people, especially growing teenagers, don't sleep enough. You must wake up on your own, not with an alarm clock. Sleep also decreases stress hormones, such as cortisol, which is very important for growth, both muscle and bone. Get to bed early, around 9 or 9:30, and sleep till 6 a.m. or longer. You must get a solid 8 to 9 hours of deep sleep. Look at a baby, it's sleeping all day and it's growing the most. I'll do an entire video about getting deep, optimal sleep because it's a super important topic for overall health. So, make sure you're subscribed to this channel, so you'll be notified when the sleep video is released soon. Food, protein. On average, people are taller these days than they were a few decades ago. One reason is because we're eating more food. Because being malnourished will for sure cause a decrease in growth. However, you must eat good, healthy foods and not eat bad foods. Because most people are eating junk, empty calories, and thus, even though they're eating more food, they are not getting enough nutrients, which is slowing your growth. This means you need to eat a good amount of high quality protein. Grass-fed beef and bison, pasture-raised chicken and whole eggs, wild-caught salmon and similar foods. I would limit dairy, because I don't like it and I think milk is for babies and cow milk is for baby cows. Maybe small amounts of yogurt. Make sure you stop eating junk protein like cold cuts and pre-packaged foods and fast foods. They are horrible for your health and your growth. Stay away from soy proteins because they increase estrogen and decrease thyroid production, both of which prevent you from reaching your maximum height. You can add in vegetable proteins as well if you'd like. Food, carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are very important, especially for growth. You need insulin to grow and insulin plus thyroid plus growth hormone equals maximum IGF levels, which causes the most growth. Mother's milk is primarily sugar and fat. So again, carbs are important. But you must eat healthy carbohydrates such as vegetables, fruits, white rice, yams, and legumes. Stay away from soda, packaged foods, chips, donuts, sugars and white bread. They have no nutritional value. Besides, high blood sugar and insulin levels will cause negative hormonal changes. You want healthy blood sugar levels, not low or high. Food, fats. And let's not forget about fats, they are super important. Fats help produce so many important hormones needed for growth, muscle, brain, and bone. Unfortunately, most people either don't have enough fats or they eat junky, unhealthy fats. Good fats are whole eggs, monounsaturated fats such as macadamia and olive oil. Coconut and MCT oil is good. Small amounts of grass-fed butter. Nuts are also good, especially walnuts and almonds. So are avocados, flax seeds, and fish oils. Stay away from the seed and so-called healthy vegetable fats such as canola, corn, sunflower, soybean, safflower and similar oils. They cause inflammation and negative changes in your hormones. Read the labels and eat natural, healthy proteins, carbs and fats. Stay away from drugs. Smoking, drinking, and doing various drugs will not help you get taller and can decrease your potential for maximum height. I also suggest staying away from caffeine products such as energy drinks, coffee, soda, and so forth because stimulants like caffeine cause hormonal imbalances and stress your nervous system. Not to mention, they disrupt the most valuable formula for growth, deep sleep. Exercise correctly. Exercise improves your hormones, which will help you get taller. And the less fat you are, the less estrogen your body produces and thus, the taller you can get. Do whatever you want when it comes to exercise. Swimming is really good. Lifting weights is fine too, especially if you do lots of pull-ups and body weight exercises. Go for higher reps, at least 10 to 15. But, stay away from exercises that can compress your spine, such as squats, deadlifts, overhead presses, and shrugs. Take extra supplements. I also suggest taking extra vitamins and minerals, such as calcium, magnesium, zinc. A good B-complex formula, vitamin C, and D are a good start. Posture and confidence. Finally, don't forget about posture. Stand up straight, chest out, shoulders back and look straight. Don't look down and slump forward. Stand with confidence. You'll for sure look a couple inches taller. You can also put lifts inside your shoes and wear boots or dress shoes, which have heels. The heel plus the lift inside the shoe will easily add at least 2 to 3 inches to you. Now, some people will think that's cheating, you're being deceptive. But, women wear heels all the time to look taller, so who cares if you do as well? If it makes you feel better, then go for it. Lastly, stop comparing yourself to others. If you're not as tall as you'd like to be, that's fine. Nothing you can do about it. Instead, focus on all the great qualities you have, as well as the things that you can improve. Like staying in shape, having a great attitude, and being successful in something that you really care about. Life isn't fair. We all have things we like and dislike about ourselves. If you can make improvements, go for it. If you can't, then stop wasting valuable time and energy on it.
Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.